Hey, ioStux here. I'd like to use today's video to share a trick that I give to my clients which allows them to get rid of bad habits easily. The example I will use in this video is poor movement in the form of spamming jump, but the technique can be applied to any bad habit you might have. Before we get into this, I'd like to quickly mention this video's sponsor, ioStux.com. If you want to get coached by the number one private Overwatch coach, head over to ioStux.com and get coached today. Whether you want a live coaching session, a pre-recorded VOD review of your gameplay, or a written assessment of you as a player, there's something for everyone on ioStux.com. And no other coaching service comes even close to the consistent results that my coaching brings. Whether you want to reach a higher rating to increase the quality of your matches or dream of going pro one day, getting a session with me will give you the edge you need. Visit ioStux.com and use discount code NEWCLIENT to receive 20% off your order. That's discount code NEWCLIENT to receive 20% off your first order. Before we talk about the trick, we need to talk about the problem. Jumping. It sounds simple, and you probably think to yourself, jumping surely isn't the reason why I'm struggling, but I'd like to go over a few of the consequences that spam jumping has. Don't believe jumping is an issue for you? Just open up the replay viewer and spend 5 minutes watching a pro player play, counting how often he jumps. Now go into your own replay and do the same thing. After tallying up the jumps and comparing them, push your jaw back in place and continue watching this video. First reason why jumping sucks, it makes your movement incredibly predictable. Yes, jumping does make it more difficult for the enemies to headshot you, seeing that your head is bouncing up and down instead of staying at one consistent height. However, it makes landing body shots so incredibly easy that you'll end up dying faster to body shots than you would to headshots if you wouldn't jump. Think of it this way. Jumping makes getting headshots more difficult, but the lower your rank, the less headshots the enemies will go for in the first place. Low-ranked players aren't exactly known for their excellent crosshair placement or their headshot accuracy. Most of them are body shot machines, so to beat them, don't make your head harder to hit, make your whole hitbox more difficult to hit. And jumping does the exact opposite. Next, jumping makes placing your crosshair incredibly difficult. Movement is always symmetrical. The impact of your movement on the enemy's aim is always going to be equal to the impact it has on yourself. If jumping makes it more difficult to land headshots for the enemies, then in turn, it will also make it more difficult for you to land headshots. Instead of being able to just keep your crosshair at head height, the enemy's head height is constantly bouncing up and down. This extra dimension makes aiming a lot more difficult. And if we are under the assumption that you are a more ambitious player than the enemies, that would mean that you would want to go for more headshots than the enemies do, who are complacent with their body shots. So, by jumping, you are essentially making something more difficult for the enemies that they aren't even trying to do, while making something more difficult for you that you are doing to yourself. And finally, jumping is terrible because it causes a loss of control, and that will have consequences on your play that you might not even be aware of. First, peak shooting is basically impossible while jumping, and it's one of the strongest movement techniques there is. Weaving in and out of cover, only exposing yourself when you are taking a shot, and hiding away while your gun is recovering, allows you to increase your survivability without any reduction in your DPS output. Second, it lowers your reaction time. You can't try to dodge enemy stuns, hooks, or sleeps if you are mid-air, since you can't control your character. But most importantly, and this is something that I want to talk more about another time, your movement and your aim need to be in sync. If you are moving to the left, then the enemy will move right on your screen, unless he is also moving to the left. This means that you need to develop ambidextrous coordination, where your left and your right hand work as one. But if you consistently jump, you rob your right hand of the chance to build any synergy with the left, because the left isn't doing anything except spamming spacebar. So when you do actually try to strafe in a 1v1, your right hand will have no clue what to do, with your left hand constantly throwing your aim off, and the right hand not being able to compensate. So now that we understand why jumping is bad, let's talk about why people jump this much in the first place. I mean, think about it. When was the last time you jumped in real life? Do you jump on your way to work? Do you jump down the stairs? Probably not. So why do we jump so much in games if we don't think too much about it? First, pro player syndrome. Pro player syndrome is a general term I've come up with that describes a multitude of symptoms, but one of them is APM forcing. It's when people subconsciously think that pressing buttons really fast will make them play better. After all the StarCraft 2 pros do it, mashing keys like crazy, so by spamming the jump key, it just makes people feel more competent. Feels cool to have an extra button to press regularly. I know it sounds stupid, but trust me, I've been doing this for a while. People do much dumber stuff without noticing just so they feel they are a better player, even if, objectively speaking, it only makes them worse. Pressing buttons fast doesn't make you a better player. Next, I guess you could call this the World of Warcraft syndrome. It's not really specific specific to that game, but for me personally, World of Warcraft is the reason why I struggled with jumping in Overwatch. Seeing how many flips your female Night Elf could do in a row as you ran towards Darkshore is fun. You spend a lot of time walking in a straight line, so you want to do something during that time besides holding down W. A fun tidbit, the record for most consecutive Night Elf flips is 7. The same happens in other games too. Whether you play Borderlands or Titanfall or any other game where you need to cross long distances, people just default to mashing the jump key while they travel to keep their hands busy. So it's only natural to take that habit and apply it to Overwatch. Without even thinking about it, you spam the spacebar as you run back from spawn because holding W is just too boring. The issue is that once you enter the fight, you don't really consciously stop yourself from spamming spacebar, you just keep going. I mean, think about a game like Minecraft. You know, in certain situations, jumping in Minecraft can make you faster. And lastly, as I mentioned before in the why is jumping bad part of this guide, jumping causes a loss of control. That's really bad, of course, but it does have one upside. It makes the game significantly less stressful and more manageable. Having to control both your character's movement skillfully while focusing on aiming as well can be overwhelming, especially for new players. But by spamming the spacebar, the game becomes more manageable. They can focus on their aim exclusively because their movement has been dumbed down to just spamming one key. Of course, this is bad, but at first people will get positive results from this. They can focus more on their aim, which means that they will land more body shots. So they don't even think about changing up their movement because when they stop jumping, it technically makes landing headshots easier, but all they see is that in the short term, their aim gets worse if they stop jumping, so they automatically start jumping again. It's a vicious cycle. You have to get worse to get better. So, how do we stop this habit? How can we make ourselves a more difficult target to hit while also giving us a real chance at landing headshots consistently without relying on dumb luck or aimbots? The answer lies in understanding what habits really are and how to best fight. You have to understand that trying to get rid of a habit is not going to give you quick results. Telling an addict to just stop with their bad habit is not going to get anywhere. So how do they get people to fix their habits? By changing them instead of removing them. Replace their bad habit with something that's slightly less bad. Don't tell an overweight person to stop eating crisps. Tell them to eat low-fat crisps instead. Don't tell them to stop eating butter. Tell them to eat low-fat margarine instead. Replace mayonnaise with low-fat salad cream. Of course, they won't be receptive to all these changes, but with one of them, they'll go, yeah, actually, this isn't so bad. I think I can do that. And we haven't removed the habit. We just made it slightly less bad. Do that step by step, and eventually they will eat the same amount they did before, as frequently as before, but nevertheless consume half the calories. It's like your family growing up. If you spend every day with them, then they will grow up without you even noticing. But if you don't see them for 3 years, it will seem like they have aged dramatically. If you try to remove a bad habit, then you will compare the day without the habit to the day with the habit before. And that just won't work. It'll be too big of a change. But if you make a small change that your brain can tolerate, maybe not even notice, then it's not going to notice what you're doing to it. So how do we apply this to our jumping problem? Well, we can't just tell someone who has a bad habit of jumping all the time to stop jumping because that change is too dramatic. That action of spamming a key with their thumb is so ingrained that they'll revert to the habit pretty quickly if left unchecked. So we need to take that habit and make a small change to it that is big enough to make a difference, but small enough to where they won't feel distracted or bothered by it. And that's remapping your crouch key to C. I mean, it makes sense. C for crouch. People who crouch on controller, bonkers. This is how the universe is supposed to work. Anyways, after we rebind our crouch key to C, we need to realize that, hey, C isn't really that far away from spacebar. How about we just move our thumb a little to where it rests on C instead of the spacebar? This way, all you need to do is remind yourself every now and then to place your thumb on C. But once it's there, and you hop in the game, every time your brain tries to subconsciously spam the spacebar, it will hit the C key instead, because that's where a finger is resting, causing you to crouch. So instead of jumping, which is terrible movement, we are now crouch spamming, which is actually pretty advanced and super advantageous form of movement. You maintain the control of your character while still screwing with the enemy's aim. You can still jump if you have to, the space key is still right there, but just remind yourself to put your thumb on C and eventually it will become a habit. We didn't remove our habit of spamming a key with our thumb. We just changed that key at spamming to something far more productive. So, as a quick extra, you might be thinking, can't I just unbind the jump key? The problem with this is that this will stop you from jumping, but it won't stop you from spamming the space key. So you'll spam the space key and nothing will happen and it'll feel super awkward. And the thing about Overwatch is that sometimes you do want your jump to get up on things like the payload, for example, or jump above an obstacle. So completely removing the ability to jump doesn't really change anything about your bad habit, and it handicaps you in game. Not a good idea. That does it for this guide. I hope that this technique of fixing bad habits has helped. This approach isn't just useful for Overwatch. Well, all of my clients have reported amazing results after implementing this technique to their improvement process. I actually had some clients tell me that they used these techniques to change other aspects about their life, like swapping the location of their vegetables and snacks in their kitchen, or putting books on their nightstand instead of their tech gadgets to reduce screen time before bed. They will still try to grab the snacks, they'll still try to pick up their laptop, but because of these changes, that subconscious action now leads to a different outcome. Instead of grabbing a chocolate bar, they'll grab a banana. Instead of grabbing their laptop, they'll grab the Hunger Games. And sometimes that's enough to go, hey, I have this in my hand anyways now, so I might as well give it a shot. Don't change your habits. Change your life around them so that good actions become more convenient than the bad ones. Getting up from bed so you can get to your laptop is going to be less convenient than just reading the book. And if that inconvenience is big enough, then you'll do something you don't like over something you do like that's bad for you. My name is ioStux, and I'd like to thank you for learning.